I think the tricky thing with getting into product management, it's difficult to have a straight path into product management.
What is your biggest motivation?
The thing I love is making our users happy. So, you know, and each company or each product manager role is different. You know, some people might be working on a product that a few people use. Some people can work on products that millions of people use. So, you know, we're a global company, so we have millions of users as well, and we get to directly see the results of our users using our products and it making them happy, it improving their, you know, their situation or their lives, and in our case, improving their safety and their comfort. I think that's the coolest thing, is to be able to work with really talented people to do that and to have that direct effect in the market and with your users.
Thank you. So as you said, product manager position is kind of a new position, maybe started like 5-10 years ago.
Yeah.
So I think many people want to become product manager, but it's kind of lack of information. So if the people who want to be this position in the future, what kind of advice you can give to them?
Yeah, I think the tricky thing with getting into product management, it's difficult to have a straight path into product management. This is starting to change now because there's a position now called associate product manager. That's basically someone who comes right out of college and joins a product management team. But this is very new, and a lot of companies still do not have this. So a lot of companies, when they're looking for a product manager, you know, they want 3, 5, 7 years experience. But that's difficult if it's like the chicken and egg problem. You know, it's difficult if you don't have the experience to get into a product manager position, but to get the product manager position, you got to have experience. So I think the best advice I would give people is try to get as close to the position as possible. So for example, if you want to build products, you're going to be somewhere connected with it. So maybe marketing, or maybe as a business analyst, maybe you're a designer, maybe you're a software engineer. If you're already in one of those positions, that's the best way to transition into product management. Mm. And if you're not, even working at a tech company, for example. You know, there are certificates now, which I do think would be really helpful. But to be honest, I think the best way is to just find the position that you could most feel comfortable doing and kind of getting your foot into the door and starting to work with teams. So for example, if you're a waiter at a restaurant and you want to become a product manager at a company, especially a tech company, maybe trying to join the customer service team or the customer success team, because you have a lot of experience working with clients, especially angry ones, and helping them to get a good experience and to leave as a happy customer. A lot of people in the customer success team, that's a lot of their responsibility is helping our customers be happy at the end of the day as a direct communication. So for example, joining that team and then working with the product managers, learning about what they do, you know, that could be a great way to get into product management, because there is no traditional way, not yet. I think in the future there might be, but right now there's still not a traditional way to get into product management. So my advice would be to find a skill that you're most comfortable starting with, joining a company, getting close to the team, and then when you have some experience, making that jump into a product manager.
Thank you. That's really interesting and useful information. So the last question is, what kind of questions will he or she be asked during the interview for a product manager position?
This is going to depend on the company that you work for. Some companies are going to be very kind of operational focused. For example, like, what are some of the specific tasks that you did or work that you did? And it kind of depends on what the experience range is. So if you're already a product manager and you're looking to change into a product manager role at another company, it's going to be more focused on around those things about specifics of the product manager job. You know, for example, what tools do you use? What products did you work on? What was KPIs? So now that mostly people are using OKRs now, but what are kind of like the analytics and the numbers and the targets that you achieved to grow your product? What were some of the problems that you went through and how did you solve those problems? Usually more specific questions. But if you're looking to join one of the large, what we call the FANG companies, for example, like Facebook and Amazon and Google, and you're not already a product manager, they're going to be more problem-solving questions. They're going to want to test you to see if you're presented with problems, how do you solve them? For example, Amazon has a very famous interviewing process now. That's a very unique, and they actually don't ask you at all what you did before at your previous job specifically, but they ask more theoretical questions, like when you had a difficult coworker, you know, how did you smooth things out, and those kind of questions. So that's a tricky thing because depending on which company you interview at, the questions are going to be quite different. But it's also exciting. It's exciting in a way because you get a bit of variety in your interview questions. And being a product manager, I think, is exciting. I think it's fun. At the end of the day, that's kind of what it's supposed to be about. You're going to get problems all the time and you have to find solutions for them. You have to make a bunch of decisions. So when they ask you about how do you make decisions, how do you solve problems, you know, don't be too nervous and don't be too scared about it. Just think about it in a logical sense. And I think that's the best way to go about the interview process.
Jason, thank you very much. Thank you for sharing your knowledge.